Hello, fellow classmates of 2020, friends and family. It has been a while since I've been able to interact with you guys, and let me just say, I miss you all a lot. I miss our community, and I miss seeing you guys every day. Some of you I've known since 7th grade, and some of you I've known for less than a year, and it's crazy to think that we've all come so far. I was asked to speak at Baccalaureate at the beginning of the year, and due to the circumstances, it's going to look a little different, but nonetheless, the message remains the same, and I hope that it can impact you guys in a meaningful way.
What would you do if you had to spend 24 hours in a city that barely spoke any English without your wallet and only relying on strangers for food and shelter? I stayed an extra day, packed some clothes, gear, and my phone, and hit the streets to see if it'd be possible to survive here without any money for 24 hours.
You just watched a video by one of my favorite YouTubers. Yes Theory creates content that inspires and motivates people to step beyond their comfort zone, face fear, and make memories. In this particular video, this guy was challenged to spend a whole 24 hours in South Korea with no friends, no money, and no phone, only relying on the kindness of strangers for food and shelter. While I don't encourage you to do this, this challenge is meant to push him beyond his comfort zone. The experience was awkward, tiring, and frustrating, but it made an incredible learning experience. He decided to push himself beyond his comfort zone to make lifelong memories. These three guys inspired me a lot for my final year of high school, and I really wanted to live out their motto, seek discomfort, for this final year. And unfortunately, I wasn't able to live it out for a full year, but I still want to relay their message of seek discomfort to you all, not just for the circumstances and this time in history, but also for this next step in our lives. I'm sure you've heard it a million times, but right now is unlike any other. The world shut down, time seems to have stopped, and our lives are on hold. Some of our parents or loved ones lost jobs. Some of us have witnessed the effects of the disease firsthand. We face difficulty, but we can't say that without acknowledging our privilege in this situation. We live in America. We each have a roof to live under. We have people to be quarantined with. We have food in our pantries, and we have access to technology. In this time, I would think that most of us aren't destitute, but we are in discomfort. We can't see our friends every day. We live with the fear that we may not go to college. We didn't get to have our final stretch of senior year events. We are submerged in a pool of discomfort, uncertainty, and fear because of the circumstances. We live in a culture that is so adamant on hard work and schedules and go, go, go that we literally need the world to stop for us to reflect. It is not easy sitting with just you and your thoughts. Even if this is a negative time for you, there is value in pausing and living in your discomfort. So I want to encourage you with this. Seek discomfort. I don't mean that you should push yourself to a point of endangering yourself. No, no, no. Seek discomfort means look within yourself to find the fears that you've been hiding behind school, work, college. Seek discomfort means the best things in life exist outside your comfort zone, outside your room, outside your phone, outside your social sphere. Ironically, we aren't allowed outside, but you can seek discomfort in plenty of other ways. Talk to someone new, someone you've seen every day at school and never talked to. Thank someone for that small compliment they gave you one time. If you are uncomfortable sitting still, I encourage you to do nothing for 5 minutes and just rest. Read a book, because I know plenty of us are uncomfortable doing that. Learn that new skill you've always been afraid to do. Seek to go beyond your comfort zone, because that is where growth happens. Let me give you another example. David wrote an entire book of the Bible about his discomfort. Trapped in caves and on the run, David lived in isolation, starvation. He was fearful of the future before him. He cries, "Save me, O my God." He questions, "Why have you forsaken me?" He begs God to answer his call. However, in David's fear, uncertainty, and discomfort, he understood the true nature of God. In the worst times of his life, he began to understand the Lord is my strength and my shield. Joy comes in the morning, and he is steadfast in love. Outside of his royal palace, he found a deep connection to God. In his discomfort, he grew to trust God, and so he thrived spiritually in his hardships. This is what I mean by seek discomfort. As you go into college, eventually, you are going to need to step out of your comfort zone. Some of you, that's going to be making new friends, or living in a whole new state, or putting more effort into your schoolwork, getting involved in internships, falling away from your old habits. That time will come, but I encourage you to right now in quarantine, when the world is on hold, to look into yourself and think, where am I holding back on making the most of this life? Ask God to search you and understand where you can grow in this time. So I hope that you can find a better understanding of yourself and learn how to thrive in discomfort.